This screencast will solve the following problem that is related to using the Bernoulli equation. So we have a 2 foot tall coffee urn that is full to the top and dispenses coffee through a nozzle that is located 5 inches above the table surface. The diameter of this nozzle is approximately 1/2 inch, and we want to know how long it would take to pour a cup of coffee. First thing we want to do in any problem is label our points of interest. So if it is full to the top, we will call that our point one, and where it dispenses, our point two. We'll call the bottom the table surface, z equals 0. The distance to point two is 5 inches, and the distance to point one is 2 feet. Next, after labeling our diagram as such, we want to make our assumptions to solve this problem. So with using a general simplified form of the Bernoulli equation, there's a number of assumptions that we have to make. First of all, we assume steady state. That means when the coffee starts flowing, the volumetric flow rate of that coffee is not going to change while we fill the cup. Second, we're going to assume that it is inviscid. There are no viscous effects involved with this. Third, we're going to say that the flow follows a certain streamline. And lastly, we're going to say that it is incompressible. In this case, all of these assumptions hold to be pretty accurate. This allows us to write the generalized form of the Bernoulli equation, which is going to be our governing equation in this problem, where the pressure at point one over the specific weight of the fluid plus the velocity at point one squared over 2 times the gravitational constant plus the height at point one is going to be equal to the same at point two. And now that we have our generalized form of the equation, we could start crossing some of the terms out. Now, we're going to assume that this little thing on top makes it so that it's open to atmosphere, and we know that the flow comes out open to atmosphere, so we could cross out our pressure 1 and pressure 2 terms and assume that it's just the same pressure as atmosphere. And the last important assumption is that the diameter of the coffee pot is going to be, we'll call D1 for the flow at point 1, is going to be much, much, much greater than that at point 2. This basically means that the velocity at point 1 is therefore going to be much, much, much less than point 2. So we could cross this term out. This leaves us with the form of the equation where Z1 is equal to the velocity at point 2 squared over 2g plus Z2. And since we're interested in the time to fill a cup, we're going to want to know what the velocity at point 2 is. So solving for V2, we're going to get the following equation. So at this point, we can start plugging in some numbers. For G, we're going to use 32.2 feet per second squared. For Z1, we're going to use 5 inches, which is also equivalent to 0.42 feet. And for Z2, we'll use 2 feet. And if we plug these numbers into that equation, we should get a velocity at point 2 equal to 10.1 feet per second. At this point, we are looking for the time it takes to fill one cup and have a velocity of the fluid. So we need a volumetric flow rate, which we'll designate as Q. And we could get this by multiplying the velocity times the cross-sectional area. And we could calculate the cross-sectional area for a nozzle. We'll assume a circular opening as pi r squared. This is going to be equal to the radius, which is 0.25 inches. And we're going to convert this into feet, since our velocity is in feet per second, which gives us the following cross-sectional area. Now we take this and multiply it by the velocity. And we get a volumetric flow rate of coffee of about 1.4 times 10 to the minus 2 feet cubed per second. We still want the time it takes to fill one cup, so we need some conversion factor between feet cubes and cups. Using this conversion factor, you should get a volumetric flow rate of approximately 1.6 cups per second. Therefore, you should be able to fill up your cup of coffee in approximately 0.6 seconds.